He was one who did what was needed in service to the greater good. He was all about the world and not about himself.
When Dr. Dan Crickbaum was in college, he went to a restaurant with a black teammate and they were refused service. He was so upset that he went straight to the coach, who brought him, his friend, and the rest of the basketball team back to the restaurant and demanded to be served. This was the moment that a switch was flipped for Dr. Crickbaum and what helped lead him on his path to serve in civil rights and the ministry. He was raised in Salem, Ohio, and influenced by the religious leaders in his community. But after working at Detroit Receiving Hospital for a summer, he knew this was where he wanted to do his ministry work.
I think he developed an affinity for Detroit when he worked here that one summer. And so he came to Southwest Detroit in July of 1967 with the smoke of the civil disturbance in the background.
As a civil rights advocate and interfaith leader, he had an extensive breadth of career. In his role as Governor Jennifer Granholm's chief of staff, Dr. Crickbaum took on some challenging assignments.
He took them with never a complaint, never resistance. He dove in. One of the assignments was to make sure that the Department of Civil Rights received the leadership and the attention that it needed. And he loved it so because it was consistent with his heart and his life's mission to elevate challenged communities and to seek equality for everybody.
He also spent 17 years as the Parks and Recreation Director serving former Mayor Coleman Young, and then moved on to be the president and CEO of the Michigan Roundtable for Diversity and Inclusion.
When he worked for Coleman Young, he actually started the first riverfront parks. He built Shane Park and St. Aubin Park. And he built recreation centers. He believed very much in positive recreation and giving kids a place to go. And then he was recruited to go to the roundtable. They were struggling a bit, and he seemed to have the perfect mix of religious and civic and government to go to an organization like that.
Dr. Crickbaum held prestigious positions for high-ranking officials in Detroit and in the state of Michigan. But no matter what job he held, he always put forth his best efforts based on a motto from when he was a child.
He went to camp in Michigan, and there was a motto about my own self doing my best all the time. And that's just how he lived. So I think he did his best work everywhere.
And as he worked to break down barriers, he used his ministry and passion for religion to bring people together. His three heroes, Jesus, Abraham Lincoln, and Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.
I think they represented for him humanity and equality and service and sacrifice. I think he tried to live up to their example. He didn't wear his religion on his sleeve, he just lived it.
He was the guy who people on the team innately trusted, the one who was a peacemaker, the one who could remind you of a spiritual passage or a poem or become a salve for a bruised soul.
Dr. Crickbaum passed away in February of 2015, but his work still lives on here in Detroit. He worked on creating the Advocates and Leaders for Police and Community to examine issues affecting police and community relations and ensuring equality in the enforcement of the law, which is still in existence today. And throughout all of his work and accomplishments, Dr. Crickbaum always made time to be a loving husband and father, raising four children.
He always wanted to make sure they had their daily fun quotient. So whether that was going out in the backyard to shoot baskets or play pickle or run to the Coney Island for a late night Coney or something, he just wanted to make sure they were always still having fun.
He was one of the best human beings I have ever met, and I think they broke the mold after Dan Crickbaum.
For charting his own path and leading our community, we salute Dr. Daniel Crickbaum, a distinguished warrior.